In this video, I will show you how to deploy Flowise to the cloud so that you can access your chat flows from anywhere. This is also necessary for integrating your Flowise chatbots into websites and other applications. So unless you're planning on using Flowise on your local machine only, this video is for you. Before we begin, I do want to mention two important things about this video. You do not have to deploy Flowise to the cloud in order to follow along with this tutorial series. This is an important step when deploying Flowise applications for clients or for your own projects. So I highly encourage you to follow along. Second, there is a small cost involved in hosting your Flowise instances online. But before you click off the video, we will follow a free solution for deploying Flowise in this video, but I will explain the benefits of the paid plan as well. But I do need to mention that the $7 per month price tag for hosting Flowise is nothing compared to the amount that you can charge for selling these solutions to clients. If we have a look at the deployment page in the Flowise documentation, we can see instructions for deploying Flowise to multiple providers. All of these services come with their own challenges and pricing. And if you want, I can create a video or perhaps a separate series for deploying Flowise to each and every one of these providers. Please let me know in the comments what you think. So I've tried out all of these providers, and Render just has the perfect balance between being easy to deploy to and really cost effective. So I will be looking at deploying to Render in this video. In order to follow along, you do need to create a GitHub account. So go over to github.com and then sign in or sign up. Next, open the Flowise repository on GitHub. I'll leave a link down in the description below. And what we need to do is create a copy of Flowise, which we can deploy to Render. In order to create this copy, we need to fork this repo. So from this page, click on Fork. But since I've already forked this, I can't do it again, but you should see a button that says Create Fork. And on the following screen, do not change anything, just click on Create Fork. And afterwards, you should have your very own copy of Flowise in your own namespace. Now, all we have to do is deploy this to Render. So go over to render.com, click on Get Started to create your account or sign in with your existing account. Afterwards, you will see a dashboard similar to this. But in your example, you won't see any records here where I have this Flowise record. This is just my own instance of Flowise that's busy updating. So to create a new service, simply click on New. Then let's create a web service. We will deploy from GitHub. Let's click Next. Here, you might be prompted to connect your account to GitHub. Or you might even see that option on the sidebar over here. So go ahead and click on that option and follow the steps for connecting this account to GitHub. Afterwards, you should see a list of all of your repos. So select the Flowise AI option and click on Connect. You can give your project a name. Since I already have a Flowise project running, I'll just call this Flowise AI YouTube. You can then select your region. You can leave the branch as main. Also, leave the root directory as empty. Then for the runtime, select Docker. Now, under instance type, if you haven't entered a credit card, you will only be able to select the free plan. And if you simply want to follow along with this tutorial without spending any money, then feel free to use the free plan. But I do have to mention that the free plan has some serious limitations. The biggest limitation is that there is no persistent storage, which means after this instance is restarted or crashes, all of your data and chat flows will be lost. This instance also spins down after a period of inactivity, which means it could be quite slow if you only visit Flowise again after a few hours or days. So if you are planning on using Flowise in a production environment, then definitely consider upgrading to one of these other plans. And for this video, I'll actually select the starter plan. But again, feel free to follow along using the free plan as well. Now, whether you're using the free plan or one of the paid plans, you have the option of entering environment variables. And we can see all the available environment variables in the Flowise documentation. And I do want to show you two important variables that we will use in this video, and that is your Flowise username and password. Because we will be deploying Flowise to the cloud, and Flowise can then be accessed using a URL endpoint, we do want to limit access to users that have these credentials. So let's set our username and password by adding an environment variable called flowise_username, and let's enter a username. Obviously, I would recommend entering something a little bit more secure than this, but for demonstration purposes, I think this is perfectly fine. Let's also enter a password, and I'll just enter password 123. You might also be interested in some of these other environment variables, like debugging, or even the langsmith environment variables. Then let's also add one more environment variable, and that is the node version. And we can set that to 18.18.1. If you are using the free plan, this is all you have to do. You can just go ahead and click on Create Web Service, and that will deploy Flowise to render. And I will show you how to access Flowise in a minute. But if you are using the paid plan, I do recommend adding persistent storage, and that is really easy to set up. Click on Advanced. Within Advanced, click on Add Disk. Give your disk a name, like Flowise Disk. Then for the mount path, enter /opt/render/.flowise. For the size, simply select 1 gig, as this is more than enough for Flowise. So we just have to add 4 more environment variables, and those are the database path. And then for the value, we will actually use the same value that we used in the mount path. So ensure that these values are the same. Then we also want to store the API key path on this disk. So we will just simply copy this value again. Then we also have to set the path for our logs, which is the same as this value, /logs. And we can also set our secret path, which is simply the same as this value over here. And that is all we need to do to set up render. Now, go ahead and click on Create Web Service. At this point, we can see that our Flowise project is being built, and this will take a few minutes to complete. But stick around to the end of this video, where I will show you how to upgrade your Flowise instance on render without having to repeat this entire process. Please support this channel by hitting the like button, hit subscribe, and comment down below which deployment providers you would like me to cover in a future video. Once deployment is done, you should see this little live icon here. And if we scroll up, we can now see this URL just below the project name. And if we click on that, it will actually open our Flowise instance. And because we set credentials in the environment variables, we now need to log in order to continue. And after logging in, we are able to use Flowise as per usual. So we can add new chat flows. And now that our project is online, we can actually make use of these API endpoints to include these chatbots in our projects. So if we wanted to include this chatbot into a website, all we have to do is copy this little script over here and add it to the body tag of our website. And you will then be able to access your chatbot using a little chat bubble, like on this website over here. And we will have a look at embedding chatbots onto actual websites in the series, but I just quickly wanted to show you the benefit of hosting these Flowise instances in the cloud. Now, as promised, let's have a look at upgrading Flowise on render. The Flowise team release new updates all the time, and these updates are not automatically applied to your Flowise instance. In order to trigger the upgrade, go to the fork Flowise repo on your GitHub account, and you might notice something similar to this, where you will see a message saying that this branch is a certain amount of commits behind. And these are all the updates that have been released since you created this fork. Now, in order to pull in all of these updates, simply look for this sync fork button and then click on update branch. Your repo will now be up to date, and If you switch over to render, you will notice that a new deployment has started. And once this is done, your instance of Flowise on render will be up to date. If you enjoyed this video, then you might enjoy this other video where we create an AI clone of Mr. Beast using Flowise. Or stick around and watch the rest of the videos of this Flowise tutorial series.